Alright, okay. Hello, hello. I'm gonna read a little poetry. It's kind of a naked experience, isn't it? Anything to do with poetry, the writing of it, it's kind of an opening, like, freedom in the mind space. So it does look as if I am, but I'm not, actually. But anyway, I have many family publishings, like, you know, from my grandmother, and she made the publishings of many poetry books. So I'm going to read this little foreword of this one. It's called The Cricket and the Lion. It's a child's story, and it's kind of a fun one. And she says that in memory of a poet. Now, oddly, I'm not even sure who wrote this foreword, but it's quite beautiful. It says, a poet, a writer, a human being, who never lost the ability to see through the eyes of an innocent. You are missed, child of the wind, dreamer of the mind, keeper of the soul. So it's kind of a very beautiful sentiment right there at the very beginning of the book. So I believe this was, because it says in memory of, it must have happened after her passing. But yeah, it's great. So it has ISBN. So I guess I could reprint these. That's a way of making something, you know. I reprint them or something, go on tour. But yeah, it's The Cricket and the Lion. And it says, I'm tired, roared the lion. I'm just tired. As the cricket patiently listened to his friend. I'm tired, he repeated. Every time I roar, every time, a flock of children swarm to my cage and stare at me. Good heavens. Every single time. They will not let me sleep or rest. I tell you, my friend, I am so tired. So this lion is being hassled by these children. And he's talking to the cricket. All right. So, well, said the cricket, it's all very simple. Just don't roar, and they will leave you alone. So now here's the advice from this little tiny insect saying, don't roar, and then after everything, you know, they'll go away. It's bad little children. Now he comes back. He says, no, don't roar. Roared the lion again. He can't help it, is how he speaks. What do you mean, don't roar? Did you ever try to hold a sneeze? Well, it's the same thing. I cannot hold a roar. Either I roar or burst. So that's that, emphatica. Fiddlesticks. Oh my gosh, that is an old word, isn't it? Fiddlesticks, replied the cricket. I didn't know that you do have a problem. So the cricket is completely confused now. He just didn't know he had all of these problems, that if he holds his roar, or he will burst. So yes, it goes on and on and on. And so the lion says, yes, I do have a problem. So this is hysterical. Now they're having a tete-a-tete here, what to do about it. And it's almost like he's going to psychiatry system or something. And when I'm happy, I roar. And when I'm hungry, I roar. And when I'm angry, I roar. You know, and just for the fun of it, I roar. So he's telling, like, what do we call this, a true confession here. He just has to do it. Just let them out an extra long... Then he says, just then he let out an extra long roar. So, a roar. There he goes. And then little children from all around, there they are. They ran up to the front of the lion's cage, right there, in front of it, again. They laughed and they pointed at the lion. And then they started throwing popcorn. Isn't that ridiculous? Bad little children. Bad little children. So anyway, so that's a cute little book, isn't it? And then we have this other one, which is quite extensive. Quite extensive with poem after poem after poem after poem. A lot of poetry, like serious poetry. Just goes on and on, page after page after page after page. We have summer in here, and we have the Great Bear. You know, it's just a phenomenal work. She was a great lady, actually. She worked for the church, the Catholic Church, quite extensively most of her life. And that was her work, you know. She had many children, and yeah. So anyway, my goodness. But then yeah, poetry. So she did her poetry, and then she got this published, and it actually, you know, I don't believe it was really for a monetary reason. It was just, you know, the sheer have to, you know, at some point you have to. And, well, she had to, rather. So yeah, it's kind of a fun little collage of her life. Yeah, she lived quite agedly to 91 years old. She was a very, very long-lived woman. Very short, also very short in stature. Very, very independent with her haute mode. There, very fashionable woman. Yeah. So there it is, her book of poetry. So looking into the possibly a reprint, and I guess that would be something I could go to the different stores as a what do you call that? The author in presence, the author helper in presence. You know. That would be something, you know, we could get the family members to do. Yeah, so, anyway, yeah, that was for the Rabiata. Where am I at that one? I don't know, I'm kind of upset with it a little bit. I didn't like the ending, and so now I almost have to restart over again, and it probably is a college course, but I'm not happy with it at all. So anyway.